clarify that.
That's good. Thank you, Ben. All right, sir. All right, everybody. I'm Ernesto Casadas, group leader for Axelion and advisor for our quality circle. Hands off. And now I'd like to introduce our quality circle leader, Brandon Sendejo.
Good afternoon, everybody. Again, my name is Brandon Sendejo, team leader on Axelion. And I'll be going over with y'all guys our quality circle that we did. So our team name for our QCC is Hands Off. And our theme is to reduce the number of X's on HYP. Okay, so our safety team commitment is to ensure the safety of ourselves and others through Kaizen development. One team, one purpose, Yosh. Okay, I'd like to introduce our team now. So our advisor is Ernesto C. Our circle leader is myself, Brandon S. And we have also a team member, Joshua S. And Thomas S. And Ernest S. And we have Ricky Hernandez and Brenda Polo. That's our team. Okay, I want to go over some of our rules that we had in place. One, we had everyone must attend our meetings. Two, be respectful to each other. Three, everyone must contribute. And four, our most important was have fun and a positive attitude. And there's some pictures of our team members here as we're going through our process. Okay, we also have our FMDS board up here. Our FMDS board is very vital to us, the information that we got for our quality circle. And I just want to highlight our FMDS board right here. And we have some pictures of our processes, some of the processes that team members are working currently. And it's just FMDS board's information we got. So our theme selection. So our theme selection metrics, some of the proposed themes that we had, some of the issues team members were experiencing was team member having trouble with setting cotter pins, one of the processes. That gave us total points of 12, so that ranked out of 4. We also had issue where the studs did not line up on our knuckle. That gave us a score of 18, the rank of 2. And we also were experiencing faults in our processes. That also gave us a score of 14, that ranked at 3. And the one that we went with was a reduced number of X's on HYP. And we'll make the work easier. We marked that a 5, we'll make it much easier. And vested interest, how many team members are impacted, and that's going to be more than 50%, so that also gave us a score of 5. And can we solve it by ourselves? That was a big one that we had, and that was ranked a 5. That was something that we felt that we all could impact, and we could all do that on our own as a group. And can we complete it in time? And that was also a 5 we could and can do. And what will happen if the problem is not solved? Gradually, it will get worse, so that was a 3. And what will be the benefit to the team? And that was safety, so that ranked a 7. So that gave us a total score of 30, so that ranked number 1. So that was our theme, that's what we went with. And on the bottom, we have our level, assessment, and planning table. After punching in the numbers, that we got put in zone D area, so that gave us in zone D. All right. So our ultimate goal was to reduce number of X's and injuries through utilizing our quality circle activities and working as one to defeat our issue. So some of the skills that we wanted to develop was public speaking. That was a big one that we all pretty feel uncomfortable with at the time, was our public speaking. So that was something that we all felt that we could definitely improve on. So we marked that at an X at the start. And understanding problem solving tools, we went ahead and marked a triangle for that. And developing countermeasures, we also marked a triangle for that one as well. Okay, so now we're going to be going over step 1.
Hi, my name is Ricky Hernandez, and I'll be going over step 1. So in clarifying the problem, we got our data range from January 2nd, June 2nd of 2019. And in that range, our team 1 team members had 78 X's on HYP for discomfort. So currently, that leaves us with 78 X's on our HYP. Our ideal is to be at 0 X's on our HYP. So that leaves us with our gap of 78 X's on our HYP. And down here, we just have a heat map of all of our processes on Team 1.
Hello, my name is Josh West. I'm going to be discussing step 2, breaking down the problem. So we took these 78 X's on the HYP, and we wanted to see and break down our processes, and found that there were 3 X's on the HYP for axle pick. We had 29 on diff 2, we had 11 on Westo 1, and 0 on diff 1. and found that there were 35 X's on the HYP for West 05. So we wanted to concentrate on that, and we broke down West 05 and found that we had 10 X's for the hands, we had 4 for the shoulder, we had 1 for the back, and we had 20 X's on the HYP for the wrist. So we wanted to focus on the 20, and we came down and broke down the process with the elements and found that on step 1 that we had 0 for installing the sub-assemblies. Step 2 we had 0 for installing the shaft nut. We had step 3 rotating the knuckle, there was 20. Step 4 installing the ring, there was 0. And step 5 installing the pin, there was 0. So coming back to step 3, team members have discomfort rotating the knuckle by hand. And so our prioritized problem at the point of occurrence is having the 20 X's on the HYP due to wrist discomfort, which was caused by rotating the knuckle by hand.
Hello, I'm Ernest Schneider, and I will be discussing target setting. As a group, we've chosen the 20 HYPs for our wrist discomfort. So we want to get that 20 down to 0, which would be 100% reduction. And this is taken from our overall HYPs of 78 to 58, which is a 26% reduction. We also have one OHS case that we like to bring down to 0, which is also 100% reduction.
Hi, my name is Thomas Smith, and I'll be going over step 4, the root cause analysis. So we started off with man, and we found that team members are following standard of work, so we know that's not the issue. Then we went with the machine. There's no cause of discomfort in progress for the machine, so we didn't follow that. Materials, there was no cause of HYP with any of the materials we have. And then environment, there's no issues, nothing in the way causing HYP. So that left us with just the method. So our method was a team member had wrist discomfort. Why? Because the studs do not line up with the tool. Why? Because the studs do not have a set location. Why? Because the knuckle line is not set standard for location for the studs. And why was a team member unable to do a visual check on knuckle line? As some of these pictures here is knuckle line. So at the very beginning of knuckle line, it's facing forward. But when we set it out to West 01, they're always backwards. So there's nowhere for the team members to check it. So that was that leaves with our problem, which is our root cause is the team members are unable to visually check on knuckle line. So our problem statement is team members have discomfort from rotating knuckle by hand. And then we have a video here of this video here shows why we have to rotate it by hand so we can install the cap and the cotter pin. So if it's sideways or up and down, it's easier for it to install.
Good afternoon, my name is Brenda, and today I'll be presenting step 5, develop countermeasures. So we came came with 4 proposals. The first proposal was the new head design. The second one was moving elements. The third one was design a new jig. And the fourth one was change standard on knuckle visual check. So for the new head design on tool, our cost was pretty high, which gave us a total judgment of X, which was a problematic between 0 and 9. The second one was moving elements, which gave us a feasibility of low and gave us a total judgment of 10, which gave us an average judgment between 10 and 15. Our fourth one was a change standard on knuckle visual check, which gave us a effect of pretty high, which gave us a negative judgment of 9, which is a problematic. And our last one, the design new jig, our cost was pretty low. Our feasibility was pretty high. Our durability was medium. Our effect was pretty high. And our total judgment was 18, which one was one of the best at 16 plus.
Okay, so we'll be going over step 6 now. See countermeasures through. We have what, who, when, and the status. So one was we talked with the team about new jig design. That was done by myself. That was on May 16th. The status on that is complete. So that just went with the team member talking about it, discussing what can we do. And step two, this was a real big step here in our process. We came up with designs that works for all team members. We went through several designs before finding one that worked for the team. And that was done by myself, by team one, on May 17th, and that was complete. And this involved us going through different ones because, as you'll see, as we go further down, we had one that didn't work. We had one that was a little bit better. And we just pretty much went over all the issues that we were having with the jigs, the ones that we were working on, the ones that we wanted for the future. So that was a pretty good group discussion on this one. And on three, we submit Kaizen. That was done by myself on May 18th. That was complete. And four, we trialed pliers on both shifts. And that was done by team one, May 23rd. And that's also complete. And we'll get further in detail on that. But that's when we got our pliers back. And we tried them on both shifts. It worked out pretty well. And five, we submitted a PCR. That was done by the TL, myself, on May 24th. That was also complete. And it's just some pictures when we were going over that discussion. Okay, right here we have our steps to success. All right, so one, team members have a group discussion about new jig design. So some of the positive feedback that we had was team members participating in the group discussion process. And our point of opportunity, team members had opportunity to talk about issues with current jig. Team members expressed concern the jig modified to one type of vehicle tundra only. So Thomas is passing the jig right now. That's the jig that we first had. The big issue that we had with that one was that it only worked for tundra only. So when we had the Tacomas coming through, the team members wouldn't be able to utilize that one because that one only works for tundra. So that did cause some downtime, and it was pretty discouraging to the team members because it didn't work out for tundra and Tacoma. So that was some of the feedback that we got on that one. So our focus is on improving the process through Kaizen opportunity. So we went ahead and we looked at that jig and we thought, all right, well, let's Kaizen it some more. Let's see what else we can do to improve the process. All right, so we got number two, new design. So team members came up with new design that works for all. Team members went through several designs before finding one that worked for the team. So right here, we have a picture of our second jig. That's the second jig that we came up with. So the point of opportunity is the tool is too big and bulky, also time consuming. But the positive feedback was that the tool functioned for Tundra and Tacoma. So on that one right there, we went ahead and we drilled another hole in it so it would line up to the studs. So it worked on the Tundra and Tacoma. But what the team members were experiencing was how bulky it is. It was a little bit too big. And also the placement of it as well. It wasn't really nowhere we could put a pouch, or we tried thinking about hanging it up, but it was still a little bit too bulky and really time consuming. So we went on to another design. We said, okay, well, let's go ahead and Kaizen this one also. Let's see how can we make it better. And if you look right here, this is a drawing that collectively together as a team that we came up with. This is a drawing of some pliers that we used to set our cotter pins. And talking with the team, we thought it would be a good idea. We could find a small piece of metal that might be able to fit in between the studs and the knuckle itself to be able to get that knuckle to turn. And also on the pliers, we set the cotter pin with it as well. So it would serve as two purposes, a multi-purpose tool. So the point of opportunity was the tool needs to be easy accessible. So something that we could get to, lightweight. And the positive feedback was the tool is multi-purpose and easy accessible. It's also lightweight. So the team members already had that on hand. So it's serving two purposes now. So that's what we went with the drawing.
You have to hold that back so that then.
All right, so three, we submitted the Kaizen. We all felt comfortable with it. We were pretty confident in it, so we drew it up. We went ahead and turned it in. Team members felt confident that the tool would eliminate having to rotate knuckle by hand. All right, and four, we went ahead and we tried pliers on both shifts. Team members were able to successfully eliminate rotating knuckle by hand by utilizing the new tool that they were able to Kaizen collectively as one team, making the process more efficient and easier to build. So after we did that, the process flowed a lot better. The team members weren't experiencing as much discomfort, and the process really, everybody gave it a thumbs up. Everybody really enjoyed it. And if you see our little graph here, it's a success. One team, one goal, all hands on deck, Yosh. All right, we got step seven.
Hello, I'll be going over confirming results. And as you can see on our video, Ernesto, You can see how it's been put in use and how it works and how it eliminated our gap of 20-0, which is 100% reduction. And this has affected our overall gap from 78 to 58 to 26%. And we have not had any more OHS cases since we've implemented this jig.
Okay, so now we have step eight, standardized successful process. We have what, who, when, and the status. So on what, we submitted PCR to standardized use of a new jig. That was done by the TL on June 3rd. The status on that is complete. We also updated the PES and the process book for West 05, putting the jig in the bar system. That way, maybe we could help out other areas, other plants, see where else they might be able to utilize the tool. That was done on June 5th. That's also complete. And the old jig is recycled and given to Torque Team for their safety concerns. And this one right here was a pretty big one, the middle jig that we passed around. That jig didn't work out for us, but it actually worked out for the Torque Team. When Torque Team comes by and they got to pull their torques, they got to do the same thing. They got to turn it also manually. So when they saw the jig that we came up with, they went ahead and tried that one out, and it worked out perfect for them. So that jig became their primary jig. And we also developed a backup jig for a necessary condition. So in case this jig breaks, we already have a backup one in place already ready to go. And that was done by Team 1 and the TL June 7th, and that's complete. And we also submitted for our Ergo Cup. That was done by the TL on June 28th, and that's also complete. Okay, so we have our positive level assessment and planning table. We started off in Zone D after we punched in our numbers. We made an improvement. Okay, we're still in Zone D, but we came up a little bit on Zone D. And a big one for us was our public speaking. If you remember, we had an X on that. We were all uncomfortable with public speaking. But after going through the process, we were able to bring that up to a triangle. And understanding problem-solving tool, we're also bringing that up to a circle. And developing countermeasures, we're also bringing that up to a circle as well. And we have some more pictures of us here on the bottom, developing countermeasures. And our next steps on QCC, addressing our issues on Div 2. We'll be bringing that up here shortly.
All right, guys, so I just wanted to go over our group reflection. We kind of came up with this one as a group all together, right? So quality circles are our team efforts. Our team members are talented individuals coming from different backgrounds, lifestyles, who have a strong ability to see an important project through to the end and have a positive impact on our own well-being. We're able to come together, motivate, and encourage each other while learning from each other and having fun. And we developed a project where we were able to mitigate and find a solution for the betterment of our team members. Nonetheless, an improvement that will leverage ourselves in our Toyota career. So that was kind of from our team as a whole. And then from me personally, some of my reflections, just the idea of persevering through to the end. There was several instances throughout this project where we could have easily stopped, and probably in the past we would have. Especially after the first iteration didn't work, I had a feeling it was like, okay, this one doesn't work. We're going to stop right here and just, you know, hope for the best. But me together with the guys, we kept pushing. We kept going. We came up with that second iteration. And certainly when that one didn't work, I was positive. I was like, well, this is it. It's going to be difficult to get a countermeasure and process that works for everybody and that everybody's going to use 100%. We might put it in process right now. We might even put it into standardized work right now. But 5 years down the road, are people still going to be using that second version of that jig? And the thought in my head was no. So finally, when the guys came up with that third version, I was very encouraged and very happy because we knew that could be something that was a permanent part of that process. And not just through the standardized work, but through the fact that that's a tool that they have to use 100% of the time. It's already part of their process, so it's already there for them to use. And then also just saw the hard work that all the team members put in. Coming in early, staying late. I'm very proud of these guys, especially my team leader here, Brandon Sandell. He's actually supposed to be on PTO right now. In fact, this whole week, and he's come in twice to report out. So I wanted to thank him personally. All right,
going along, Ernesto. I want to thank the team. I wouldn't miss it for anything. These guys done a great job. Just looking back, reflecting on it, I've been here for maybe about 13 years already. Been fortunate to be here with the company for 13 years and working on different areas of the line. Sometimes you get the attitude from the team members that something like this is impossible, but utilizing our tools and working together, they're able to see that the impossible is possible. So that was something big, being able to see them work together collectively as a group, team effort, being able to do that. And also the training that we've had with our quality circles, it really motivated me and it really helped me out for some of the issues that we did have. I remember reflecting back on our quality circle training that really helped me out to be able to get to where we needed to get to and kind of motivate the team and push all through where we needed to go. And I'm really proud of the guys. They did an awesome job. As a team leader, you know, we don't want to see any of our guys marking X's. We definitely don't want to see any of them get injured. So the time frame that we're able to accomplish this in was pretty remarkable. It was really good. I was really proud of them. We were able to collectively as a group attack it. And we had one jig. It didn't work out. The guys didn't stop there. We kaizened that one a little bit better. That one still kind of slowed down the team a little bit. The same thing. We had focus on it, and we're able to get to where we needed to get to with what we have now. And I told the team, I mean, through our guys' hard work, not only did we help ourselves, but we also helped our torque team as well. So torque team no longer has to put their hands on that knuckle either. They have a jig that they use as well. So going along with Ernesto, I'm proud of the guys. They did an awesome job.
So by doing this quality circle, it greatly helped me develop my problem-solving skills, not just as a team member, but helping me develop team leading skills as well for my future. It's also helped me with my public speaking. I'm the type to shy away from any kind of public speaking. So by presenting now, it's getting me more comfortable with talking. Overall, I had a great experience working with this group, and I'm very proud of what we were able to achieve as a team.
Well, I thoroughly enjoyed the process. As far as for personal development, it improved my problem-solving skills, presentation skills. So there was the personal development in it, but I also appreciated the collaborative and collective effort that we all put in, because it was a lot of coming in before shift and after shift and discussion during breaks and lunches. And so it was a enjoy. I enjoyed being able to work together as a group with these with my team members here, and it opened my eyes to some other issues we have on our other processes. And has given motivation to try to attack those issues and improve those issues that we have moving on to DIP 2, where we've already have pinpointed something that we can attack. And also just being able to, the time that was spent with each one here, I appreciate and I'm proud of what we achieved because we eliminated risk that we had in that process, and we improved the safety within that process, and not just to us, but to anyone who steps into that process. And so we're just really proud of what we were able to accomplish.
So I take this one a little bit personally, because I was the team member that got hurt on this process. So I really liked seeing how this team came together. I was able to get this done in a quickly time, so we don't have another injury, because it has one time an incident that happened, and it could have happened to anyone. It's like the next day. So I'm glad that we were able to get it done as quick as possible. I've been part of multiple quality circles, and finally getting one completely finished and seeing the results as they are, it's really good to see.
Hello. I've been at TMMTX for many years. I have done many quality circles, and every time my skills improve to problem solve. This is my first completion of a quality circle. This is a great feeling to finish this with my fellow team members. This was a fun activity to work with my team. We have become closer as a group. I feel I have imparted my skills and knowledge to the next generation of team members. I am grateful for all the support from all fellow team members, my team leader, and members of management for all their input. I look forward to applying my QCC skills to other areas inside and outside my shop.
Hi, I'm going to get a little bit cheesy right here, but I decided to provide a quote from Kaworu Ishikawa, and I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing it, but he's one of the developers for QCC, and it goes like this. I have to read it verbatimly. The first concern of the company is the happiness of people who are connected with it. If the people do not feel happy and cannot be made happy, that company does not deserve to exist. And I feel like it's relevant to what we do in QCC, because this is like the first time that I really done a QCC and I was received with open arms. I don't build this process, but I work as like in front on the other side from it, and I can see like the daily struggle, even the torque team coming and having to rush. And it's been really meaningful because they also gave me like the freedom to express myself, to the trust to work on the project. So it we also brainstormed a problem. We were able to set goals, achievement, but as well, like I saw like how everybody came together. Like I really didn't talk to a lot of our peers outside from work, and from now we're like talking. It made us more together. As well, like after this, like during this week, I've seen like every like a lot of people in our like section participating in quality circles, coming with ideas, and that's pretty like motivational. So it's pretty inspiring, and I really liked it.
All right, thank you. This concludes the end of our presentation. So for me, each quality circle brings a different dynamic each time we see a new quality circle. For this quality circle here, what they brought is they had a team member on their team that was injured. And for them, they weren't going to accept that. So that day that the team member was injured, they started staying after shift to problem solve and to implement a temporary countermeasure. And they didn't stop there with that temporary countermeasure. They met every day until they were able to get to where they are today. So their perseverance today, or what they did with their team, is what that got them here today, but also made that process safer for anybody else who builds that process. And for me, I was able to see the uniqueness and the diversity in the team. Every skill that everybody has, everybody brings a different skill, whether it's their public speaking or whether it's their innovation through creativeness on the jigs. But everybody brought something to the table. So I just want to say thank you to the team for your commitment and your dedication to completing this quality through the end. Thank you.
Thank you very much. My safety declaration is to keep the rule always. It's a really good activity, I think. And the idea is very good. And also step is very good. First you try to create something, the first step one, and try to improve to step two, and also more improvement for step three. This is very good story for QCC, I think. And maybe next step, maybe to eliminate the rotation. I hope you try to continue the Kaizen. I hope you want to do that. But anyway, very good Kaizen. Thank you very much.
I was going to ask a question. So I'm Suzanne Kazunas. I'm a new vice president as of Monday. So I've been here all of 3.5 days. And my safety commitment is I will listen and respond to team member concerns and teach others to do the same. And I was going to ask you how you got this done so quickly, but Letty basically answered it, because you had a lot of passion about what you were doing. And yesterday, Ben and I were talking about Quality Circle and how important it is that you choose a theme that you're passionate about. Not a theme that the management tells you is a problem, but a theme that is important to your process. And so I really think that shines through in today's presentation, that you guys selected something that you really cared about and you got it done really quickly. So really great job, and I'm really pleased to see not only the theme selection, but you saw it through when you had trouble. So anyway, good job.